A very good morning, my dear students of class 9th. Chapter number 4, Hearts and Hands, is being taught nowadays. You please open page number 70. Yesterday you studied up to the line, it is 7 ears for counterfeiting. Now start from here, page number 70. Oh, said the girl, with a deep breath and returning color. The girl took a long sigh, deep breath, and the color of her face returned. She was satisfied with what he said, with what the other companion of Mr. Easton said. Oh, said the girl with a deep breath and returning color. So that's what you are doing out here. A marshal. You have become a marshal here. Oh, very good. My dear Miss Fairchild, said Easton calmly, I had to do something. When I came here, I thought that I should do something. Money has a way of taking wings unto itself. And you know it takes money to keep step with our crowd in Washington. Money is very important thing. Money has to do each and everything. So I wanted to earn money. And I saw this opening in the West. I saw this opportunity in the West and came from Washington here. And well, a marshalship isn't quite as high a position as that of ambassador. Marshal, the post of marshal, marshalship isn't quite as high a position as that of ambassador. He was ambassador. Mr. Easton was ambassador in Washington. Now here in West, he becomes a marshal. So she says, Miss Fairchild says, and asks to Mr. Easton, it is not a high position as that of an ambassador. The ambassador, said the girl warmly, doesn't call any more. He needn't ever have done so. You are to know that. And so now you are one of these dashing Western heroes, fashionable Western, showy Western heroes, and you ride and shoot and go into all kinds of dangers. Now you have become marshal. You have become a dashing, fashionable, showy, and now you will ride and shoot and go into all kinds of danger as you have become a marshal. That is different from the Washington life. When you were ambassador there, and you have become here a marshal, there is so much difference between that post and this post. That is different from the Washington life. You have been missed from the old crowd. The girl's eyes fascinated, charmed. The girl's eyes charmed, went back, widening a little to rest upon the glittering handcuffs. The girl's eyes rests upon the glittering handcuffs. She was continuously watching the handcuffs. Don't you worry about them, miss, said the other man. Don't you worry about them, miss, said the other man. All marshals handcuff themselves to their prisoners to keep them from getting away. All marshals handcuff themselves to their prisoners to keep them from getting away. Mr. Easton knows his business. So he handcuffed me properly. Mr. Easton is very smart and he knows his business. Will we see you again soon in Washington? Asked the girl. Will we see you again in Washington? Asked the girl. Not soon, I think, said Easton. Easton knew it that he is going to Leavenworth prison for 7 years. But he hidden it and said, I know, not soon I think, my butterfly days are over, I fear. My youthful and enjoyable days are over, I fear. I love the West, said the girl, irrelevantly, unnecessarily. She said, I love the West, but here I came. Why? The girl is giving a reason here. Her eyes were shining softly. She looked away out of the car window. She began to speak truly and simply, without the gloss, without the external show of style and manner. She said, Mama and I spent the summer in Denver City in America. Mama and I spent the summer in Denver. She went home a week ago because father was slightly ill. She gave the reason. I could live and be happy in the West. I think the air here agrees with me. Money isn't everything, but people always misunderstand things and remain stupid. I could live and be happy in the West. I like this place much, but people think money is everything, but it isn't. Money isn't everything. People always misunderstand things and remain stupid. I am compelled to go there, say Mr. Marshall, growled the glum-faced man. In deep, rumbling sound, harsh sound, he said, Mr. Marshall, this isn't quite fair. I'm needing a drink and haven't had a smoke all day. Haven't you talked long enough? Take me in the smoker now, won't you? I am half dead for a pipe. The serious glum-faced man said that he wanted some drink. He wanted to smoke as well. Sorry. The bound travelers, Mr. Easton and the marshal, rose to their feet, stood up from there. Easton with the same slow smile on his face. I can't deny a petition, request, prayer for tobacco, he said slightly. It is the one friend of the unfortunate. Goodbye, Miss Fairchild. Duty calls, you know. He held out his hand for a farewell. I can't deny a petition for tobacco, he said slightly. I can't deny a request for tobacco. It's the one friend of the unfortunate. Goodbye. They bid goodbye to Miss Fairchild and went from there. It's too bad you are not going East, she said. You are living in the West. It is very bad. It is too bad you are not going East, she said, reclothing herself with manner and style. But you must go on to Leavenworth, I suppose. Miss Fairchild understood that Mr. Easton is a marshal and he is going to his companion to Leavenworth prison for 7 years for counterfeiting. Yes, said Easton, I must go on to Leavenworth. Yes, it is my duty to go there. The two men sidled down, moved furtively the aisle into the smoker. The two passengers in a seat nearby had heard most of the conversation. Said one of them, the two passengers were sitting over there near them. One of the passengers said, that's Marshall, a good sort of chap. good sort of fellow, good sort of man. Some of these Western fellows are all right. Pretty young to hold an office like that, isn't he? Asked the other. Young, exclaimed the first speaker. Why, oh, didn't you catch on? Say, did you ever know an officer to handcuff a prisoner to his right hand? All the while, two passengers seated nearby have listened to their conversation. One says that he seems too young to be a marshal. His age is less than to be a marshal. He seems to be too young to be a marshal. The other says, Mr. Easton is not a marshal. He is the counterfeiter. He is the fraud. Did you ever know an officer to handcuff a prisoner to his right hand? This ending surprises the readers and makes the story interesting. You must know that left hand of Easton is free. Left hand. Mr. Easton's right hand bound with the left hand of the real marshal. Mr. Easton's right hand is bounded with the left hand of the real marshal. The real marshal told Miss Fairchild that he is the counterfeiter, while Mr. Easton is the marshal. But what was the truth? You knew it now. The chapter is over, my dear students. If there is any problem, you please ask me. Thank you so much.